I know I don't believe in you. So you're totally justified if you choose to ignore me. I've been meaning to get something off my chest. I haven't read your book in its entirety. Just can't bring myself to invest that much time into a work of literature that's received so many mixed reviews. I'm an avid reader. There's just so much stuff out there. Okay, here goes. I'm planning on having premarital sex. I know you're not gonna be 100% on board with it, which is why I was wondering if we could discuss your rules surrounding forgiveness. I'm under the impression if I ask you to forgive me, you kind of have to. Which is, it's pretty awesome, I'm just gonna say. If I'm off base, let me know. Otherwise, I'm gonna move forward as planned. Amen.
Alrighty then. Wow, I could probably speak for an hour on the logical and theological fallacies in that clip from a movie that, well, it's not really even worth mentioning, so I won't. But what that reminded me of is actually the alleged logic of the atheist John Loftus, and how in his book he wrote an explanation as to how he came to determine that there is no God. And I kid you not, I'm not exaggerating, this is the way that he explains it, okay? He was supposed to be a Christian. Okay, he wanted to commit adultery, which is faith commitment, the Bible, Christianity, etc., forbids. He claims the Holy Spirit was dwelling within him. Now, this is actually questionable as per 1 John 2:19, that states, they went out from us, but they were not of us. For if they had been of us, they would no doubt have continued with us. But they went out that they might be made manifest that they were not of us. Then he says that God, through his Holy Spirit, did not stop him from exercising free will. So he went ahead and committed adultery, and therefore it's God's fault that he committed adultery. And since God forbids but did not stop him from committing adultery, therefore God doesn't exist. Again, I'm not kidding, I'm not exaggerating. This is his explanation for why he became an atheist. And not too long ago, I did a research project where I read statements by over 100 atheists as to why they became atheists. And they may not be this bizarre or outlandish or pathetic, but they're not exactly impressive. I'll put a link to that research project below. But there it is. That is actually John Loftus' reasons for becoming an atheist. He wanted to commit adultery. He did so. God didn't stop him. Therefore, it's God's fault. But forget that, because God doesn't exist. Or otherwise, he would have stopped John from committing adultery. Even though, by the way, John was aware that God had already spoken on the subject and condemned it, so he shouldn't have even entertained it as a thought. But that's a side issue, apparently, in John's mind.